Chainlink, one last dip. Welcome back, guys. It's Crypto Rocco from Rockstar Trading Channel. In today's video, guys, we'll be sharing with you the exact price we're looking to buy the Chainlink dip. We'll be sharing with you massive news for Chainlink. Chainlink and Arbitrum are working on the Ethereum ecosystem. This is huge news for Chainlink, so we'll be sharing with you the massive news that can have huge price implications for Chainlink in the long time frame. In the short time frame, guys, with Bitcoin and Ethereum dipping, Chainlink could have another dip, but it doesn't really matter. You know, if you like the project, does it matter? You know, people want to buy Chainlink and think it's a better project when the price is pumping. If you like the project, you should be happy with this dip. If you guys have been watching the YouTube channel, guys, the one of the best dips we've bought, it's probably one of the best trades back in 2020, was buying this $1 dip. I said if Chainlink drops into here, guys, just blindly buy some. This was our zone. It literally dipped into it, and this ended up being the bottom in Chainlink. I'm not saying this will be the bottom, the zone that I'll share, but if it does get into there, I'm definitely buying some. So stay tuned. If you enjoy the video, watch the video. If you enjoy it, then you can give us a like and subscribe at the end of the video. Now let's get into the video. So Chainlink, guys, is one of the only coins, if you look at the monthly time frame, where the price is just up, up and up. Even during the bear market of Bitcoin in 2018, Chainlink has continued to go up. So it's a coin that we really like. You know, if you've been watching the YouTube channel for me, you know, I made a Chainlink video back in 2018, 2019 level, and it's been one of the best performing coins. I still hold some Chainlink from then, but my trade, we've been stopped out of that trade. But what the point I want to make is, guys, Chainlink fundamentally is a great project. And if you do your own research, if you believe in Chainlink, what Chainlink are trying to do, if you get a 20-30, you know, 80% discount, you get in on that. You could be wrong, but that's better than buying here and be 80% down. If you buy it here and it doesn't go up, then yes, you know, you could look to exit. I'll share with you the exact dip strategy where you can, you know, look to get in. There will be a bounce for you to exit. If you have been watching the channel, guys, I shared the exact Bitcoin dip. You know, we bought some, we sold half in the bounce. In the YouTube channel, guys, I show exactly where we're looking to buy and sell. In the Rockstar Trading Group, guys, there's live stream courses and Telegram group where I can post when I'm buying and selling. There's a webinar as well where you guys can talk and ask questions. If you are interested in that, I'll leave the links below. There's a special monthly offer to trial us for a month to see if it's for you. So Chainlink, guys, the key level I'm looking for in Chainlink is this zone. If Chainlink price comes into this zone, I'm going to look to just blindly buy some. I think there will at least be a bounce. This was our previous zone. Chainlink dipped below it about 20%. But then you had it, 60% went up. Again, don't use leverage if you don't know what you're doing. If Chainlink sharply dips into this, you know, $10 zone, I'm going to look to ladder in some buys in Chainlink. I'll share some trade setups if it carries on breaking out, similar to what we looked at there. But, you know, look at how Chainlink came into here. And that's the where you sold the bounce play. And, you know, it came into this level 34 zone. This was the 50% 618 zone where I said, come if it comes into here, take some profit. Now we want Chainlink to hold the $20 level, and as long as the $20 holds, you can look to buy some in the dip from trading point of view. But if it sharply dips another, you know, 20, 50, 60%, then just blindly buy some. That would be my trade setup. Again, this is not financial advice. Watch our YouTube channel, use this information, and you know, use your own analysis to see if you want to use it or not. Talking about news, the biggest news I can share is the Chainlink and Arbitrum. This is massive news for the Ethereum ecosystem, and the point I want to make is what Chainlink is going to do is build smart contracts using entirely new approach to secure off-chain, let me repeat that, off-chain computing, providing previously inaccessible scalability for running Solidity. So this is the key bit, and you know, we know all the issues with Ethereum, everyone's trying to resolve it. So Arbitrum working with Chainlink, this is massive news for me. Check out our Twitter account, it's me and my friend, you know, he posts all the news and stuff, and I try to post the chart, so check it out. The Twitter account, if you're interested, is Trader Rocco. But this is massive news for Chainlink. Looking at other news, you know, Chainlink is one of the projects that always have fundamental news. If you search for like Tron and other currencies, there's just talks about price. But if you look at Chainlink, there are some positive news. This is probably a bit of a dramatic news headline, you know, fight climate change. But the point you can see, you know, the reason why I like Chainlink so much is because they are trying to resolve real world case issues. You know, they're actually trying to get adoption. The problem is, you know, expanding these practices globally. And the agriculture is a high-risk field for farmers in the developing world. So the Chainlink, what they're trying to do is, you know, the climate change will do is shift rain patterns, and it will shift how rain patterns will be utilized. This is where the decentralized crop insurance through InsurTech protocols like Arbol that uses things like Chainlink and Ethereum are truly amazing. So you can see the real world use case of Chainlink, what Chainlink is trying to do with the Oracle and, you know, the real world data connecting to blockchain. I think is, you know, that's one of the reasons, you know, Chainlink is my favorite, one of my favorite cryptocurrencies. I talked about it in 2018, 2019, and I still talk about it. And the other positive news is, you know, Chainlink being used in the DeFi. People that are into DeFi, they're using Chainlink. And it's not just this project. There's hundreds of other projects that are using the Chainlink services. Those are the key news, but the one that I'm most excited about is this. And I said it at the end of it that, you know, Chainlink, this news might not affect the price straight away. But long time, guys, this is huge news. If this can help the Ethereum scalability issues, Chainlink will moon. I don't talk this channel. I try to talk about risks before I talk about, you know, mooning and bull and crazy stuff. But I do think that that is huge news for Chainlink. So from trading point of view, guys, you know, if it comes into $20, you can look for a, you know, bounce play. You know, whatever strategy you use, please make sure you have a strategy. You can learn our strategy of how we look to get in and all that good stuff. But please make sure you have a strategy. You know, if it comes in here, if it's a trend line break that you use or an indicator, whatever you use, look for something like this. And I don't think, you know, I don't want to scare people saying Chainlink is coming below $10, but if Bitcoin loses the 30k support and drops, I think Chainlink and all the most of the cryptocurrencies are going to have a dip, and it could be an opportunity of a lifetime. And what I'd prefer is if it comes into here, a sharp bounce. And, you know, I'm not saying it will bounce straight up like this, but something, you know, sharp pull, sharp bounce as soon as it comes to that level gets me really excited. And, you know, I'm not saying I'll catch another generational bottom, but I'll look to for a trade. And I could be wrong. You know, I've been wrong before. There's been trades that I've taken and it kept on dipping. You know, there was a level here on $2 I bought. It bounced. It couldn't. I had to exit and got back in after. You can go watch the videos. The call I made around here was a, was it here or was it this one? Can't remember which one it was. Let me have a look which one it was. I believe it was around here. That call on, I made it on YouTube and I said I was exactly when I was buying, and you know, that was ended up being a good call. But you know, that's the level I'm looking to buy. If you are interested in Chainlink, ask yourself, why will I FOMO in at $50? The project, the fundamentals doesn't change whether it's at $50, it's at $10. If you believe in Chainlink and cryptocurrency, that is a level I would look to buy. So thank you very much for watching this video, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you have enjoyed it, guys, smash that like button, subscribe to the channel and turn on the notification button. Like I've said, guys, I think this could potentially be one last dip in Chainlink before it starts moving higher. Comment below and see if you're, if you agree that it's going to be one last dip, or do you think it's going to, you know, carry on going, you know, whatever your price prediction is. Comment below and let's have a discussion. So thank you very much. Smash that like button, subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you guys soon with another great video. Thank you very much.